of you. And we knew we'd get a good attendance, but nothing like this. So we should be okay. It's our pleasure to welcome Horst Hellman, who was here a long time ago, as many of you know. I didn't personally know Horst in those years, but when I first started the West Coast Diner School, I was aware of a gentleman called Horst Hellman. I never got to meet you. So Horst is currently based in Singapore, and he currently flies around the place giving lectures in Manila and Malaysia and all over the place. And I hope I'm as active as you are when I'm your age, Horst. Horst has three daughters and a huge family ranging down to three great-grandchildren. So it's with great pleasure we welcome you here to our humble house, and thank you for joining us again.
That's good.
Yeah, thank you very much. It's a very special moment that I'm here with you in this house that I already know where Eric was alive. And here in Australia, it began that I was talking about Waldorf education. And the very last day before I returned to Germany with my family, we were 10 months in Australia, so there was something that we had in this society, a lecture on Waldorf education, and Anne was working at Netherlands University and had a meeting over there and said, I can't come because Waldorf education is there. And Ted McGowan, at this time the dean of the university, said, oh, never heard about this education. You can't have this lecture in your small group. Just take him here to our Netherlands University and let him speak about this. So that happened, that I gave this lecture, and for Ted McGowan it was electrifying. Yeah. He could not sleep. He went on the internet and searching and this and that, and spent half a year in England to study Waldorf education at once. Came back. We start the Waldorf school. Okay. That is a very special story. And so since then I came always here to Australia to feed my baby. And then I don't know what was the last time I was here, I can't remember. But on my journeys in Australia, it happened that I met people from the Philippines, and they came to my place in Germany, and I was invited to come to Manila, and we had a 3-month course, and we started the school with 6 children in a garage. That was the beginning in the Philippines. And now we have many schools in the Philippines, and my youngest child is in Davao, where I'm in February. So I'm, since then, here all around in Asia and not so much in Australia. You are now grown up, and so I'm very happy that I can meet so many friends and also the schools here. Yeah. because of this activity here in Asia, that is in Bali and Bandung and Yogyakarta and Malaysia, KL, and so, yeah. So for me, it's now that I stay in Singapore only a few weeks and then go to the next country. And but my home is still in Germany. Yeah. So my grandchild did an experiment that she got from Emoto. She said, oh, that's interesting. I want to test. So she put three jars with rice and water in. And then she put that in a room where nobody else was allowed to enter. And they were far apart from each other, these jars. And she went into the room and thought, thank you. Thought, you idiot. Ignored the total for a month. And what came out after the month? You see here, this where it was thank you had a nice perfume. This where she was scolding idiot, was not so bad, but still fungus coming up. And this what was ignored was rotten and had an incredible stench. You can try this. You can try this. So, this is hardly to see this from above. Yeah, that shows even more how this is rotten. So we have our thoughts as a quality that is influencing life. Yeah? Our life forces, our etheric forces are influenced by this way we think. Therefore, some people have, when there's a good hand with plants, they have probably a very good mindset towards plants. So, this in the background, my nice jacaranda greeted me. They thought, I bring it in. With this in mind, we can see there is something beyond that usually is not thought of. So, when we have neighbors, partners, children, how we are thinking, this is important. We are influencing life forces, the etheric forces. Now, I have the topic to speak about these spiritual powers in the world. And they are also influencing our thoughts. You know, maybe Jackie Chan, these movies of Jackie Chan. Is that familiar? Jackie Chan? Yeah, okay. So, Jackie Chan, when he, not all movies, but especially in the youngest movies, there he appears in white dress. And he is very skillful, a present of mind. Yeah, he has a present of mind. That's what Rudolf Steiner says we have to develop. Present of mind is an enhanced perception. So, this he has, and he has no egotism in the way he wants to have. Because destiny brings him something that he has to transport. He is not aware on this. It might be gold or whatever. In the end of his movies, he always has nothing of this. He could also be craving for this. He does not at all. And then he believes in the good of the people. So when he is transporting this special thing, then he suddenly is attacked. He's attacked by a very well organized group, organization, with the latest technology on one side. And he is astonished. Why are they attacking me? And he, because of his presence of mind and his martial art, he is able to escape. But then there is another group that is very like hooligans, also very good fighters, but not so organized as the other group. So then he has to do with this. And so he's always have to do with this group, haunted by this group, haunted by the other group, and now he has to go through this. And he is not angry at all. He is somehow always astonished. Why? And then, in his innocent, he finally brings things in order, and whether the thing that everyone is behind is gone, or he brings it. And he is, so to say, with one group, this is chaotic, but strong. And the other group that is very well organized. Everything can't be better. And then there is this Jackie Chan. Is dealing with this, with all these qualities that we as human beings are striving for. Not angry, not craving, just being in the moment. What is the task to do? And that is on a very high level, I would say a very high spiritual level, to go through this disaster. And when we look into our present world, we can see both. Yeah, we have these terrorists. We have on the other side this banker world. Yeah, and we as human beings, somehow we have to wake up. We have to wake up. What is going on? How are they working? So these forces, the children get to know in the Waldorf school in the very first lesson. But of course, the teacher is not talking about this background. It's not necessary. So the first thing is that the teacher lets the children draw a curve and a straight line. These are the principles where the physical world is built up. Everything what we have here in life is made of a straight line and a curve. Yeah? So these are the world principles of the outer world. And we can this bring into our soul life. There we can have this that is on this side. We would say this person is more towards the artistical side. And then we have this. There, this person is more on the logistic side. And when we see this in a spiritual sphere, then this is awakening and this is sleeping. So we have body, soul, and spirit here. And we have this in our brain. We have the right hemisphere of the brain. This is the artistical, the holistic part. And we have the left brain, where we have the more rational part. And what we do in Waldorf Education is to have a curriculum that is connecting both elements through arts, through a kind of thinking that is a new thinking. It is a flexible thinking, that is a thinking that becomes able to connect with life processes. And eurythmy is very important in this, to understand these processes. So a flexible thinking, a new thinking. And because all the world is trained, highly trained in this kind of scientific thinking, so those people are not able to understand what is a new thinking. Yeah, they have experts in their way of thinking, and that there is a new thinking necessary, that's very hard for them to come to this. And Waldorf Education enables a connection between both hemispheres of the brain, like this. And that is a modern thing. You know, this is more the female side, this is a more male side. But our time now needs this connection. This was necessary for developing the technology. But the technology gets stuck. And it needs that also the female side is developed. And then we come to this new thinking that we are striving for. And the whole world of curriculum is focusing on this quality, to develop the new thinking. Now, we have here in this picture this side. And we know this is Lucifer. This power, yeah? The Luciferian power. So here, on the right side, we can see this is what we can describe as that as I did. That is more the Luciferian side. And to get another word for this side, this is Ahriman. Ahrimanic forces. And they are in the world. In all straight lines and all curved lines, we have Lucifer and we have Ahriman. In everything what we, how we manage our life, we have Lucifer and Ahriman. You know, these spiritual forces, they have the only playground in the human being. Everywhere, they are forced to follow this, what is their task in the world. And only the human being gives them the possibility to play off. And when we are having a tendency to be strong here, on the Luciferic side, then it turns out to be evil. Jackie Chan is to tell you, yeah? That is one evil. But also the other side, as we see in our culture, civilization, that is also an evil. So we have evil one and evil two. And that is very important to know, when that we get away from good and evil. No, we have two evils, and the good is the activity that we are doing here, Jackie Chan. And so good is always the activity. And therefore, we are never ready with this. Our lifelong, we deal with these both sides in us. And that's wonderful, otherwise the development would stop. So the consciousness is important for both sides. And in our time, it's especially the Ahrimanic side. The Luciferic side has been in the historical past. Dirk Steiner even gives the year 3000 before Christ, where Lucifer incarnated in China. And now, 3000 years after Christ, Ahriman is due to be incarnated. Well, we are not so far away from these 3000. And you know, it is for Ahriman. He only can work when there is chaos. Then Ahriman comes and says, I have the solution. Yeah? As long as there is not enough chaos, there are people influenced by him and preparing his way to get the rulership. So this is something we have to focus on this side. I mean, Lucifer and Ahriman are always two sides of the coin, yeah? On one you have the number, Ahriman, on the other side you have kangaroos or an animal or plants is Lucifer. So we have always, when there is Ahriman, there is also Lucifer. They are working together. And so far, when we look at Ahriman's side, we also should learn to see, where is Lucifer here? How is Lucifer leading us into this? And there's Lucifer is in the astral body. Ahriman is in the etheric body, in the life forces. There, Ahriman is attacking life forces, astral forces. And when we have our weaknesses, and after life, we can work it out. Because with power of our ego, yeah, it's karma, then we can balance our astral body, we can balance the etheric body. So the reincarnation and karma says you can deal with this. And in our times we have the third spiritual power. They are called Asuras. So, we have astral body, etheric body, and you have the ego. So there's the Asuras, they attack the eye of the human being. And since the Third Reich, the Asuras are there. And my next lecture here will be about the Asuras, what they are doing towards our eye. And Lucifer and Ahriman are very nice helpers in this. So, we have in the Bible also two devils. Yeah, we have the devil. And we have Satan. So these forces are known in all cultures. The old Persian culture has almost an Ahriman. Now I'm going to focus on the Ahrimanic side. And there 12 streets through which Ahriman is preparing his incarnation. 5 streets are within the human being, and 7 streets are coming in culture and history. So, beginning with the 5 streams within the human being. There is Ahriman bringing into the world fear. This is his impulse to bring the people fear. Fear of death. What kind of fears can you think of? Everywhere where there is fear, there you have Ahriman. And in Singapore, that is so number one in education, yeah, PISA test just now, Singapore number one. So it's a best education, what the economy thinks is best. And now I'm living in Singapore. I know the families. I live in families who have children in the mainstream. And there you can see that the whole family life is full of fear that the child is not doing, but not performing and learning the very best. And they have tests and tests and exams one after the other. And the children are forced to go to Sunday school and to evening school, and when the child is not doing well, the father is shouting at them. It is such a terrible climate, fear. And that comes from the school, from the teacher. They also have fear that they are not performing so good. And the education ministry jitters because we might be not number one in the world. So this enforcement is so strong that children are committing suicide. And that happens now very often. 12-year-old children. And there is no family life possible. No, see, what are you? What is in you, dear child? So this is something we can say that goes all around the world. This kind of PISA test is streamlining in the curriculum that is everywhere. So then everywhere this fear in jitters. In Germany they now want to bring a digital kindergarten education. Yeah. So this is Ahriman. So what can we do? We can make us fearless. When we are doing a step towards meditation. So every meditation that we can do, that is a moment where Ahriman has no say. Okay? You get into this quietness and all unrest is wiped out. And when you are doing this over many years, then you will also come to your own self, to your own I. And when you meet your own I, in this moment that you are losing this fear. Fear is not attacking you anymore. And in our time, we have so many young people who are already fearless. They say, no matter what is, I go my way. You do your test, I don't care. Especially in Waldorf, parents, you see this courageousness, because in the Asian culture is always this so strong, this power to perform. So, but we also see that in our time, we are so busy, kept so busy. And the more busy you are, the more you get rid of your humanity. Yeah? If you slow down, then you have time to talk to your neighbors or with your children, whatever. Yeah? And the more you get busy, the more you are getting into loneliness. And so it needs to have also this persistence to go this and to make it as a task and become aware when I am occupied by this terrible business. Then the next is the hardening of the soul. Hardening of the soul, and that leads to growing egotism. So, there we have elements in our time. What is a competitive sport? Me. Yeah, I am the one. Ambitions in this, that is bodybuilding, for example. It's making you tough. And so always be the first. That makes you hard. And then when we also see on this music sector, where everything becomes louder and louder and harder and so, yeah. So what is, it gives us a middle. This is just going over the walls. And that is at heart. Also shocks is hardening the soul, yeah? And that starts already with the babies. So now the day is that you have the children in the pram, the mother is here, the child is there.
Yes.
And maybe there is a roof. There is no connection anymore. Yeah? So this child is meeting something that comes here and it has no explanation for this. So what happened there? Yeah, it is lost alone, like having a baby on a big soccer field in the middle. So alone. And here the mother maybe has a phone. Yeah. So this is autism. You have an imagination for autism. There autism starts. It's very different when you have the mother with the baby like this, and here the mother, and the views are meeting. This is bonding. And we have so many children now who are towards the autistic line. Yeah. So there, the mother can give comfort when something happened. There's this loving view that meets. And what comes from here is leaving. So what is leaving is not dangerous. And the mother can, by view, explain and so on. So here, this idea is really hardening the soul. These prams, these strollers, are inspired by Ahriman. How can you do this? Construct such a stroller. So then, of course, greed, yeah, greedy. So when you make money and most of it, yeah, any greediness. When also when the children are allowed to do what they like. I want to have this, yeah, you get this, when they are too young. Yeah? Then they are becoming a slave on their likes and dislikes. And the ego has nothing to do. Can't fight this. It's too weak. So that is leading into this egotism. So I just give some ideas. I leave you with this going on. Yeah? What is in our time? The third in us is lie. Lie, deception. Lie, deception, lower sensuality. Lower sensuality. That Ahriman brings. This to lie, lying, is something that we have so much here. We think of this election of Trump, yeah? What is around this? What can we believe in this, what politicians say? But we have also to see that here the mainstream school is educating towards this because of the tests when all the mistakes are punished. So what is it? Students try to betray and deny that they have, that they make mistakes. And then when they perform well, that means they are getting an award, and that from kindergarten on, that configurates the soul towards corruption. This kind of education is education towards corruption, because they are corrupted by this kind of rewarding with grades. And they don't work when it doesn't pay. And the more it pays, the more I open my purse. And I mean, those people who are the leaders have the highest education, so to say. They are the most corrupt. And we have really to see that it already starts there, bribery and corruption. We should not be astonished. Waldorf education, the mistakes are welcome. No punishment, not at all. You look at it and say, oh, you have a mistake. Or that shows you that you have a weakness. Do something to overcome it. Ask somebody, and so on. So they never had any fear to make mistakes and to admit that there is a mistake. There is no, we welcome these mistakes. They are this mistakes which are bringing us forward. And then we have, for example, also alcohol. Alcohol is cutting off from the spiritual world. It is creating an anti-ego. So when we want to strive spiritually, we can't do it with alcohol. We can do it, why not? But we can't get really further. So we have to see when the world of alcohol is also something that is going towards lower sensuality. And there have been so much, I don't need to talk about this, just open your papers and you see what it is about. Then, what we have here as a training, the soldiers to kill. And you know that these games, video games, are coming from the soldiers training, because they had to learn to pull the trigger without any second where your consciousness could get in. So that is doing this. And so our children are trained with the computer games, just this, that your heart is wiped out and there is no second to think about. You are reacting like an animal. And so this lower sensuality, it's also a matter of lower sensuality that we have to see. Then we have also, for example, the terrorists. Rudolf Steiner has a lecture on terrorism. There he talks about this, that when the souls are incarnating, they are full of ideals. And then they enter this education system, and what they get to know is only rationality and materialism. No fairy tales, just comics. The comics is just something where children are learning to laugh about cruelties. So there is a strong attack on your conscience. And from there we come to this, that the children incarnated, they feel, I have been born with something, what is my aim? And I cannot find it in this rational, materialistic world. So when they are growing older, then they still have this and say, I don't fit into this world. I have a different world in me. I must destroy this world and build up my world that I have in me. And that is, they are becoming terrorists. And they are becoming terrorists because the heaven in their soul starts to speak. And they have no way to bring it into a healthy way, into a healthy connection. They just think, I built my world and I destroy this old world. So that, what I understand, is the reason for terrorism. So, what can we do here? That we are striving to understand the spiritual affairs, to understand the spiritual world, to judge. And that starts with honesty. Strongest honesty is here the answer. Honesty to myself. Honesty. This is the beginning, but needs courage, this kind of honesty. And it is widening our love. You know, in the education, our thinking always wants to be open. That is a quality of thinking. And we have our immune system. This is rejecting everything what is foreign. So this polarity we have here, it has to do with the etheric. These are the qualities of the etheric. Immune system, thinking. And when now the people, the children learn, there is no God, there is no truth in the fairy tales, there is no, and so on. All these no's are in immune system. So I get in my thinking an immune system. But because it is one, the etheric is one. So the reaction is that here, this immune system is letting things in that it would reject before. The immune system gets weak. And the therapy is, for example, art therapy, where people learn to get rid of their no's, and then the health comes back. That is what is a therapy. And one of education, again, is the therapy for all no's of the world. That is opening our thinking, and by this is overcoming lie and deception and lower sensuality. The fourth in us is clairvoyance without effort. I will talk about this in my next lecture on the Asuras, especially. But there are many occult schools which say, oh, it's so easy. You have to get into spiritual realms. No much effort. Now we have to be aware on this. What this is also saying, it makes you happy. Happiness. Yeah. You are happy when you are following this. And you are getting rid of your daily trouble. It really does. But, you know, it's like here Lucifer is waving, hello. But if you see how that come in, it has to do with people with educated in this way, as in Singapore is going to happen. Yeah. So the soul needs some nourishment. And then they just jump onto this, and that is so well. Yeah, that does so well. So, also, Ahriman wants to avoid pain, no pain. Yeah? But pain is necessary in our karma. Ahriman says no to pain, and also this kind of groups say, you get rid of your pain. But we have to understand the pain, and by this, saying yes to the pain. Then, yeah, that is just came to me. This world here also says, just a moment. Oh yeah, back to this here with no pain. That also comes in, you know, Adolf Hitler, Third Reich, he killed those people who he said this life is not worth to live. Euthanasia, yeah, killing these people, euthanasia, and he wanted only the strongest and not caring for the others. And so we call it Holocaust. But now we have this Holocaust all over the world, free birth, with all this what is done, yeah, in pregnancy. Then the mother has to decide, oh, maybe my child has this sickness or that sickness. No, kill it, send it away. It's also something where Ahriman is behind. We had to think about this, what these disabled people are meaningful in our world. So that, otherwise it is a world without mercy. So we have to learn that life cannot be without pain. That we see, learn to say yes to pain and to suffering, and that the pain also has to do with our karma. So there comes in the idea of karma, reincarnation, and karma. So then the fifth is spiritual sleep. Ahriman wants to bring spiritual sleep. So, for example, when we have the children in kindergarten, there it is already so that these children are not able to play out with what is in them. In the mainstream, they always have programs and sit there from 3 years on and learn the letters and all this, and only a short moment where it seems to be free play. But when it's Montessori, it is not free play, it is a program. So taking away this freedom to get to your own impulses. And then they are already taught materialistical explanations. So the world is this, and the animal is this, and they are not learning to observe something by themselves, to experience it. I was with a class 5 in Bangkok in Khon Kaen in the zoo, and this one of students, class 5, they were so dedicated to each animal. And there came another group from a mainstream school that, oh, here is a lion. Oh, there is a tiger. And they were through this, and we couldn't see everything because the children were so dedicated to this and observing. They are not filled up with labels, this is. They have learned to experience by themselves. And then this is the moment where the individuality is allowed to show. So play in the childhood, free play, this is what we need. Otherwise, the children are put asleep spiritually. Where those children who learn about the dwarves and the angels and all this, yeah, for them the world is much richer, for example. then it comes also from the science, where they say there is no soul. Why should we care for the soul? There is no soul. Sir Francis Crick is the discoverer of the DNS. And he has said, you and your joys, and your sorrows, your memories, and your ambitions are in fact no more than the behavior of a vast assembly of nerve cells. A vast assembly of nerve cells. And their associated molecules. Who you are is nothing but a pack of neurons. Pack, dear packs of neurons. Although we appear to have free will, in fact, our choices have already been predetermined for us, and we cannot change that. And he says there is no soul. So, when this is the basis of the kindergarten teachers I see in Singapore, how they are dealing with the children, yeah? They are not caring for the soul. So, what we are doing is a Goetheanistic approach towards the nature, and that learn the children in a very young age already. And so that the thinking is guided by following the feelings. The children first are in the feelings, and that the thinking widens through the influence of the feelings. So, what kind of language do we have to find to speak to children? So my mother was ginger when the cousin died in an accident. Everyone was shocked and I was weeping, and in the evening she took me out of the house in the front of the door and showed to the starry heaven and a sky and said, look, Horst, look, this is Holger. You know, he has this, is a star over there. You know, and I feel this moment so much in me. It was so meaningful. I was always looking then for this star. And all this what was here, yeah, that is the way that we can find a language for the children. When this getting free from spiritual sleep. And I just mentioned this book by Dr. Eben Alexander, Proof of Heaven. Some, you should read this. A high educated brain scientist got a stroke, and then he, after 12 days, brain dead. But his wife said, no, don't take him from the machine. He came back, and what he is describing in this book is unbelievable. It is pure anthroposophy, without knowing, and that is also something what is in our world. You have so many anthroposophists who are speaking in their own way. Yeah? So, therefore, we should see what quality is in this. So now we come to the seven streams within our culture and history. So the sixth is satisfaction through prosperity. Ahriman is now, you see, in the world economy, yeah, is based on prosperity. Everyone. And that means having the GMO plants, having the pesticides, everything just to prosper. And the manipulation of the genetic code plants, increasing the productivity. And then we have the pollution, see in Beijing, yeah. And then the people are coming along and say, oh, we have a program. Yeah, and then they come with a program that comes from this old thinking. And this program seems to work, but after a while, oh no, it doesn't work. So we need a new program, a new program. So this kind of thinking with programs is not effective. And so it creates even higher, greater problems. And there is, for example, the IMF is a very dangerous organization. You should read this wonderful book, The New Confessions of an Economic Hitman. This is a guy who really worked for Ahriman, and now he is giving a confession. He is full of pain about this, what he had done, and now he is on the other side and makes everything, tries to make it healing again, what he had helped to destroy. What he has described is the way how Ahriman works. He is not speaking about Ahriman. I don't know if he is aware of this. But this is a book about Ahriman, how he works. So, what we can do here is that the Waldorf schools are connecting both hemispheres of the brain through our curriculum. And there you can become able to, later in life, to find solutions for problems that are healthy. And there are so many solutions there coming from this kind of education. That means understanding the life forces, understanding the four ethers, very important, the four ethers. Because this is understanding life. Science understands only three ethers, and therefore they got stuck. So, studying the four ethers and arts, so that we are opening up to the art of what is behind the work. Because art is much deeper than usually. So, the seventh is splitting into smaller and smaller groups. So that's what we always can observe, that everyone, every group wants to have their own rights, their own state within what was a state, now wants to become their own state. And within one group, they want to press this group. At the moment in Germany, it's very strong coming up. quite dangerous. And so that is increasing the specialization, and that starts already in school. We have the separatist movements, we have the fashion, yeah? What shoe do you have? What shoe do you wear? Yeah? Oh, you don't have Nike, you don't belong to us. So, being the best at school, that, for example, with a highly gifted students, yeah? So they are then directed into this, what they are gifted for. But it should be just the other way around. Yeah, but it opens up, because those highly gifted, they have difficulties to learn how to learn. To learn how to learn. And that they are doing by learning something where they are not gifted. And when this talent comes up very early, then it is up to the 12th age, from the previous incarnation. So when we bring this to the child, bringing this, we work with the previous incarnation and bound the child to this, and not leading the child into the future. What is the own aim for this incarnation? So what we can do here is, for example, social skills like music, orchestra, choir, youth movement. But also, when you are here in the groups, you are meeting weekly. Yeah? So that is something for groups here when you come from far and so on. Yeah, but there, when you have these meetings together, that means you are a group that is able to connect on a higher level with all the other groups. So that is creating this spiritual being, anthroposophia. Yeah, we are creating this spiritual being, anthroposophia. So this what we are doing. then that eighth, that the intelligence becomes evil. This is very clearly to see in our world that this high intelligence is making people not responsible for the whole world where they are. Here you see it very much. That it turns to be out evil, and if you have the movie Skyfall in mind, yeah, there is James Bond, number 007, and he fights with another one who once had been the same guy as James Bond. So he fights against somebody who is as well trained as James Bond. And in the end, James Bond is winning. Why? Because James Bond believes in his motherland. And the other one has lost all belief in anyone. He was disappointed from the leader of the Secret Service, M, and so that was his hold where he was fighting for, and he became evil, has no hold. James Bond had this because he had no idea. So, from this, also making profits and betrayal and all that. So all the intelligence, when it has not heart involved is evil. Intelligence itself is evil. It needs the heart. So, again, the Waldorf education with bringing both hemispheres together is the healing for this evil, so that Ahriman cannot come in. Is understanding life processes. The ninth is the mechanical explanation of the cosmos. The macrocosmos and the microcosmos, how they are belonging together. So when I was here in Perth at the Sternwarte planetary, and the astronomers talked to me about all these numbers and what is it, showed me this. And so I said, okay, and what does it mean here for us on Earth? No, nothing. We can fly to the Mars or Moon. Yeah, that is there not a connection between the movement of the Venus and the five petals of a flower? No, no, that is a mystery. No, no. Yeah, so they cannot make anything. They explain something, but that there is more in the cosmos. So everything is explained from this point of view. So the heart is a pump, yeah, and the metabolism is a factory, and the nerves are cables, and. So the cosmic thought has no place in this. And what we have to do is widening our thinking. And there, Rudolf Steiner speaks about the 12 viewpoints, that we can look into the world under 12 different viewpoints. And every one of us has not all 12. That means when we study these viewpoints in a group, then we can see, what possibilities do I have? And then we start to listen to each other under this aspect. What is your viewpoint? What is your viewpoint? So the Goetheanistic approach and studying the 12 viewpoints, and that we understand what is behind matter. So at this, even Alexander said, before my stroke, for me it was only matter and no spirit. After my stroke, I say there is spirit and matter. And that's a from a very materialistic viewpoint to this insight. So for him, the mechanical explanation of the cosmos is not existing anymore. Then, 10th, the small groups are leading the world. Very small groups. And if you study this book, then you know these groups. And interesting that here he never can give a real name. There is this group. But when we understand Ahriman, then we know who is the leader. who is inspiring these small groups to what? So it's also a way to make these minds of people perplex, so that you have difficulties to understand what is meant, and helpless. Yeah, the minds and souls are made helpless. And also these small groups are kindling wars. The IMF has a big role in these kind of wars. They create hunger and chaos. And you know, the statistics are used for propaganda. And with this internet, yeah, it's so that also now in Germany, the upcoming elections, they are thinking, what happens? How is our election now influenced by this kind of perplex, making the minds not to know what they should do? So, here it helps only when we find a judgment. For example, is it with love, and is it letting people free? Freedom and love in this, what is said, is told to us. Or are we forced to this and that? So this has to give us a freedom, but with love. So it's also an inner striving for us to come to this. So the 11th is Ahriman is working through ideologies, phrases, routines. Ideologies, phrases, routines. So, ideologies with no tolerance to others. Also doing something without consultation toward the others. Then change the meaning of words. For example, when you have the bomb that was dropped on Hiroshima had the name Trinity. Trinity that was dropped on Hiroshima. Or when you have the fish with their bones, fish is a symbol of Christ. And now you have only the bones. Yeah, so this is somehow this making fun of this, what is in the beginning a Christian symbol. Or when you have names like, with contradiction, National Socialist Party. So national and socialist is a contradiction. Or when we have the defense ministry, yeah, it is a war ministry. They should say war ministry. When our soldiers are in Afghanistan and everywhere, we are not defending. Although, you know, our former president, Horst Köhler, on his flight back from Afghanistan, had journalists. And they asked him, why are we in Afghanistan? And he said, yeah, to protect our interest. That means we need the raw materials. Aha. Uh-huh. is that fighting for the freedom of the others? I mean, that was something that came out from him, and 2 weeks later he had to leave his office. Yeah. He was early. So also all the phrases that we know, the empty words spoken by the politicians, where we can see that also the government is in the service of Mammon. So what here is helping us to, I always try also to see what brings us beyond this. So that is also again understanding the threefold organism, the social organism, the threefold social organism. So brotherhood in economic life, freedom of spiritual life, and equality in law and rights. And when we are teaching mathematics in the class one, then we are saying, so what is nine? So then the children say, that is 4 plus 5. And what else? 7 plus 2. And what else? 3, 3, 3, and so on. So many solutions. When they are taught, 3 plus 4 equals, there's only one solution. And this is homeopathic remedy. When the children learn this, to see that one problem has many solutions. So that means we sit, think in a parliament, they have a problem, and then they are asking, and your party, what is your idea? And your party, what is your idea? And what is your idea? And now we try to find the best solution. This is what is based here. But what is it in parliament? It's just everyone fights the other, and I am right and you are wrong. Mm-hmm. Yes. This is when you are taught like this. this is fostering this kind of openness. Yeah? You are open for many solutions. So, the 11th was this. Now the 12th is a materialistic understanding of the gospel. The churches, meanwhile, see Jesus as a very simple man from Nazareth. And the churches see much more that's helping people in need than really progressing towards a new interpretation of this, what the gospel means. The church has become like social workers, and they are not understanding the mystery of Golgotha, what happened there at Golgotha. And they are not able to understand reincarnation. And understanding the two Jesus boys. So, also the spiritual spiritual content of the festivals is lost. It's just a fine tradition where one feels well. So it would need here an spiritual understanding of the Christ being. And Rudolf Steiner has this as one of his center points. So with this here, we have a magnifier on this, what is happening in our world today. Christ is, we have three, Steiner says, we have in our time of consciousness soul, three tasks. One task is understanding the mystery of Golgotha. The next is understanding the evil. Understanding the evil. And the third one is understanding reincarnation and karma. That is our task. And with this, we would also get a relationship to Ahriman. That means experiencing Ahriman as a friend. That means that we are aware when something is approaching us. This comes from Ahriman. He is a power, and we, with our eye, have the ability to use this power of him and of Lucifer. Yeah. Thank you very much. Questions?
That for me was great, because that really helps to identify the...
Can you stand up then, the others?
What I really liked about that is it really helps to identify these forces and what they do. And what I'm trying to understand is, with my understanding of God force as an expanding self, perpetuating, for want of a better term, force, it's always moving outward. These dark forces, or all the angelics, whatever you like to call them, what powers them? They're disconnected from the God source. What powers them? Do they? Because they seem to need us to live, don't they?
Mm-hmm.
So is it fear that gives them their power, or what? Mm-hmm. Is their life force? Do you understand what I mean?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Isn't it in understanding the problem, which you've done, that you start to solve it? The actual act of understanding.
Yeah. but what drives them? What drives them? You know, the spiritual world, there is absolutely no freedom. In the spiritual world is only necessity. Yeah, how they work, no freedom. And the human being, as a spirit, enters this sphere and brings into this world of necessity something that is disturbing this order. So the spiritual world has to deal with this, with our impulses. And this gives the progress also in the hierarchies. So I feel that Lucifer and Ahriman are there as messengers of the spiritual world to activate the human beings. And by this progressing and well, it's a necessity for the progress of the spiritual world.
As we live in a dualistic.
Yeah. Yeah.
But the originally powers that fell, that did not follow in obedience to the spiritual world?
Yeah. Yeah. But you see, the first fall into sin came through Lucifer. Yeah? Oh, look, the world is so beautiful. Yeah? And that was the beginning of the ego. Yeah? Feeling yourself. Because when you feel that it's beautiful, in this moment, you are there and have a self-consciousness. Yeah.
There's also that picture of the Luciferic impulses in the hierarchies provide that pushback that makes things come together. You know, we've got to have that pushback against us to find the strengths within us and aspects like that. So the opposition we feel from Lucifer and Ahriman is actually a gift because it creates our strengths.
Exactly. And when I came in here, there was a very nice about a human being, and I bring it just in another way. So the human being has a physical body, has the etheric body, has the astral body, and has the eye. Yeah? Now, this is the paradise that is in the beginning. And then, now, the eye begins to be active on the astral and on the etheric and on the physical. And this is a progress that finally we are here. Our astral becomes the sentient soul. So, sentient soul is because of our eye working. And the etheric becomes the intellectual and mind soul. And here it becomes the consciousness soul. And when this development through the eye is going on, then we come here to spirit self, this etheric becomes life spirit, and this here becomes spirit man. So we come from body, soul, to spirit. And this here is then the, here we have the first Adam. And we are here, we have the second Adam. That is the man of the human, of the future, where we are on this way. And here now, with the physical body, when Steiner says physical body, then has two aspects. One aspect is just the physical substance. But he does not mean this. He says this is the indestructible body, or the phantom body. Phantom body. It's different other names, yeah? So the physical substances are hold together through this our resurrection body, yeah, as well. And this is the development that we can say consciousness, soul. That is the development of this uncorruptible body. And this happened of Golgotha, that this uncorruptible body, you know, the human being corrupted this body. And so when you are, and Golgotha, you know, with the two Jesus, yeah? One Jesus is in a heredity, he comes from Adam. When you look at this in the Bible, St. Luke, comes from Adam, and the other one comes from David. Yeah? Or Solomon? However. So, this and the unification of the two Jesus. So, here on Golgotha, this phantom body came out into the world. That is a deed of Golgotha. That now this phantom body is available to everyone in the world. You don't have to be Christian or whatever. You can be everywhere. The moment where you have freedom and love, then you connect to this phantom body of the Christ. And this is now, we can connect with this towards this here. And then we come to the new Adam. And therefore Christ is present in our etheric world because of this body. And then, yeah? And then, just a short sketch, the human being. We have thinking, feeling, willing. That is the soul. And then we have our eye. And that works on the three. And whether here we have our passions, so our needs, that is the lower eye. And then we have our ideals where we are striving to. That is our higher eye. The world of ideas that's striving, that can go on and on. This is this here, this way, that is here. Yeah, our higher self. And so we have three eyes. We have this eye, we have the higher eye, and behind here we have Christ. This is the world, the eye of the world. So in our striving, here we can see this is our eye that is higher, there is Christ. Jesus Christ. And there is the connection that we as human beings bring into the higher world. That's the development. Yeah? To your question here. And then here, the human being has become an angel. That is the angel state of the human being. That is a spirit of freedom. That's the 10th hierarchy. You're becoming the spirits of freedom. You see, Jesus Christ, Jackie Chan.
Question I've got, you know, when you were mentioning before about Lucifer incarnated about 3,000 years ago in China, then and the thought is that Ahriman will do so in about 1,000 years time, roundabout. What about the Antichrist? How does, because I read that he's kind of around,
that is Zorat. That is Zorat.
That's Zorat.
So
he's already incarnated?
No, not Zorat. Zorat never incarnates.
Okay. Okay, so
no.
One of these
offsiders. No, it's yeah. We have to see Christ on the one side and
yeah.
Zorat here,
oh.
And Zorat is the Antichrist.
Right.
And here, Lucifer, Ahriman, and Azuras are his servants. We are the servants of the Antichrist.
So Lucifer, Amos, and Azuras are the servants
They are, so to say, the puppets on the string.
And so the Antichrist has not, you don't think has incarnated?
No, never incarnates.
Oh,
no.
Because that's him there. So I'm confused about when they say that there will be a sort of an Antichrist. Is that's going to... Is he just going to use someone to be like a figurehead to make it look like they're going to follow him? I mean, that's...
No, that is Ahriman. Ahriman is a figurehead. Yeah, and Ahriman makes a human being to a figurehead. Yeah.
You said that we can experience Ahriman as a friend and we can use his power. Would you be able to give an example of how we do this? Like, you know, perhaps you have done this in your life where you recognized Ahriman's power and then used it.
Good sentence question. I have to look into my life. I can't answer at the moment, too fast.
May I answer this? Try to answer it.
Yeah.
In the Waldorf, in the Waldorf place, the paradise play.
Uh-huh.
After eating of the apple.
Yeah.
Then it is not a disaster, because God in that play says that, look, how is Adam so wise now?
Yeah.
Like God, because he realizes good and evil.
Yes.
There might be an answer. Or this as well.
Yeah.
If we realize this, then we can move forward. In the play as a God.
Yeah.
Yeah, because we are conscious about good and evil.
Yeah. I think it's not possible to answer your question. Yeah, because when you think of this here, maybe I have to see, maybe fear, that I overcame fear in my life. There I have examples for me, yeah? And how to wake up from spiritual sleep and so on. Yeah, that is...
I was taking what you said to mean Ahriman as a friend in the sense that it gives you something to strive against.
Yeah.
It's like the pain that is beneficial.
Yeah. Against myself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That makes you stronger.
Yeah.
Through
that
your strive
that
and
is
creativity.
Our shadow. Yeah. Our shadow. So. Our shadow is made of Ahriman and Lucifer.
Yeah.
There we meet them. So, that it can be a very harmless shadow, that I am a German. That's already part of the shadow. That means, how can I widen my being that I'm not appearing like a German?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that when I go to another country, I must have my bratwurst and sauerkraut like this, yeah? And how can I widen myself? But of course I cannot deny or win the way my parents educated me, yeah? They bring some shadows in me. Naturally, my mother said, Horst, you have to finish your plate.
Uh-huh.
Yeah? Insisted. And I did. And since then, I have the urge I must finish.
perhaps in part answer to Natalie's question, something, and I think Natalie's heard me say this before, but with my path of trying to understand how these forces are at work, with recognising, well, I recognise that Ahriman's behind technology. I know Lucy's in there as well, but Ahriman with technology. So I created the habit at the end of the night when I turned my television off, for example, I go, thank you, Ahriman, for your gifts.
Exactly. Yeah, that is a strength, yeah. On a plane here, in front of me, a family, three children and the parents, and on the 4 hours flight, they didn't speak any words to each other. Everyone was hooked at the computer. Yeah, no words and no thinking for yourself.
No.
Yeah, that's Ahriman. No thinking for yourself. No speaking to each other. We have 27% of the children coming to school in Germany who have deficiency in the speaking. They have to go into a training before they enter school. Nobody talks to them.
Yeah,
yeah. At home, they don't talk. Everyone is just occupied by this. They don't learn to speak. That's Ahriman. Yeah. Yeah, I think you have some something to chew.